evening and welcome to Ending the Day with God on Wednesday the 13th of September. Our opening music tonight was the Benedictus, and this evening we continue our theme looking at the life of St. John the Baptist. Kindling Spirit, come, inflame our waiting hearts.
Consoling Spirit, come, you know our every need.
We gather in the presence of the God of wholeness, in the presence of compassion's Son, in the presence of the healing Spirit.
Tonight may we be one.
Christ is always present when we gather in his name.
Tonight we welcome him as healer.
This evening's reading comes from St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 1. And you, child, will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation to his people in the forgiveness of their sins, because of the tender mercy of our God, whereby the sunrise shall visit us from on high, to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. And the child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until the day of his public appearance to Israel. Thanks be to God.
And now, our reflection. To anyone brought up in the Anglican tradition of the Book of Common Prayer, these words, the words we've just heard, will be deeply familiar. In cathedrals and parish churches, they are said by those at morning prayer every day. Read from dusty prayer books, from modern editions, or from a mobile phone app. These words circumnavigate the globe constantly. As the hymn writer John Ellerton, who lived from 1826 to 1893, put it, as o'er each continent and island, the dawn leads on another day. The voice of prayer is never silent, nor dies the strain of praise away. For it is always morning somewhere on earth, and there is always a group of people saying their prayers together at any time. The sun that bids us rest is waking our brethren neath the western sky, and hour by hour fresh lips are making thy wondrous doings heard on high. These are indeed wondrous doings which we speak or sing daily, the doings of God who has muted and then opened the mouth of Zechariah. Like Thomas after him, Zechariah doubted, and then, when presented with incontrovertible evidence, he praises God. Doubting Thomas believes and says, my Lord and my God. Believing Zechariah sings the hymn we know as the Benedictus. Hymns are not always sung to God, nor are they always about God. This praise is addressed to baby John. It is a hymn because it extols the works of God yet to be revealed, which also makes it prophetic. It is prophecy about a prophet to a prophet, and Zechariah is the incredulous father who ought to be both proud and ashamed. Proud of his son and ashamed of his doubt. Every day, Lord, may we praise you, ashamed of our sins, but proud of the knowledge of salvation you have prepared for us. Amen. We come now to today's prayers. Father, we pray for all world leaders and those who advise them, that they may make good decisions and act wisely. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for single parent families, for families under stress, and all who are separated from loved ones. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for the mentally ill, the physically damaged, for the lonely and the fearful. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for those who have come to the end of their earthly life, and for those who miss them, or never had the opportunity to put things right with them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we bring to you our secret hopes, our longings, and our gratitude. Amen.
Amen. Now use the words that Jesus taught us as we pray together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, God, for your love for us, strong and nurturing.
We give back our lives to you.
Thank you, God, for our minds and bodies.
We give back our lives to you.
Thank you, God, for the day that has passed.
We give back our lives to you.
After creation, God rested.
We give back our lives to you.
Peace to the land and all that grows on it. Peace to the sea and all that swims in it. Peace to the air and all that flies through it. Peace with our God, who calls us to serve.
Amen.